So in the last class, we were going through the agile practices and all. We'll continue that. But before we get into this agile practice, right, yesterday we have gone through the UI, user interface, and user experience design from Sarthak Goyal, a security architect, Akamai Technology Bangalore. Right? How was that, Arpita? How was that? Arpita?
It was good, sir. Like, we got to know a lot of things.
Yeah. But what happens is you feel that it is a theoretical thing. But when you do that, you must, it is an experience, okay, shared with you, right, whatever they were doing it, right? And I've asked him, okay, next part, next week we will do that, right, where he can show some of the user interface created, good, bad, and kind of things. And also we said that one will be adding, right, okay, assignment to you people. Okay, you can do it in a group. It is on Adobe XD, right? For all your mini project user interface required, you'll be designing that one and you'll be presenting it. That is after Deepavali, right? So you'll be submitting that assignment. You will get a 1 week time, learn quickly and do it. That will be your festival, right? That will be your festival, right? Please understand that, right? So with that, things will keep moving. And after this, today I'll be sending a feedback form to you, right, about the UI, UX design, whatever we had in part one. And I wanted you all people sincerely fill that one, right? Please do that. And also, I've asked this Sarthak that your exercise, whatever you do about the UI design for your mini project, I'll be sharing to them, right? They'll be evaluating and they'll be discussing with you also, right? That's the kind of an handhold things we have decided, and that's how this small session that ends about the UI and UX design. Is that okay, all of you? Arpita, can you acknowledge?
Yes.
Right.
Yes, sir.
It will go in multi-part. Okay, that's good. Right. So now we'll be back. Before I get into the other part of an agile practice, let me tell you about the simple few things which terms we have to get into. One is legacy system, right? When we talk about the legacy system, the system that which is existing, old one, which has time tested, right? So we say our grandparents are legacy in our family, right? That means they're all time tested for all good and bad, right? These things. So all time tested system we call legacy. And this legacy system always, right, people get adjusted to that one, and change people try to oppose because they have adjusted to all the previous environment and all. That's the one thing. Second thing is when a technology change, when the user comfort change, when lot many flexibility and all other things we get it, features we get it and all, right? We need to migrate from legacy system, whatever that is there many times, into a new one. Legacy system will be get transformed into new one. So there is a lot of problems that you face, right? So one of the problems, when you make a transformation from legacy to a newer kind of things, right? Understanding the design, understanding the documentation, right? That's one of the big part, because, right, if all design are not documented properly, and the runtime entity and what is seen in the design document, if they differ, right, then you find very difficult to make the working system, fully working system, into a new platform, right? You are migrating to new platform because not the reason that one, the old things are not working properly. They are working perfectly right. But the things, what happens is that you need to, as a part of the keeping in line with the trends and all, new programming paradigms, new technological paradigms, new features and all, people prefer to use new features, get into more of user comforts. Yesterday we were talking about the user experience, user comfort and all these things, right? People wanted to get into that, right? So working system, when you transform the documents, design documents and executable code, source code, they are to be perfectly intact and they should gel with each other. The executable code should be exactly same as what the source code is there, and source code is what exactly the design is there, right? So maintaining the document is so important at this stage. and updated documents, right? So please, study also, you have seen that one, the user interface is to be designed first and then to be used, rather than, okay, do whatever you want sitting in front of computer and then take a print copy and put it as a part of the design that you have designed, you have done it like this. This is a bad practice, and the majority of his students, they do this one, which I wanted you people to avoid that. So that's why it's an exercise I'll be adding in a Google account, Google Class, right, where you will be designing a user interface using the Adobe XD, the open source, he said it, right, and submitting it, that one shortly. I will add it today or tomorrow, I'll add it. but see that one, the Diwali festival holidays are 14th, 15th and 16th, and deadline I'll be keeping it on 17th, right? This is the next, not next week, right? You will get one full week time, right? Right, so that 17th of November, you will be submitting it, right? UI design, and also on Adobe XD, how to use it, that kind of a small manual. You can work in the group, right? Then when we come to the software maintenance and all, so please look into that. This is the most important thing, right? So when we talk about the software maintenance, there are two types of maintenance, corrective maintenance and adaptive maintenance. Corrective maintenance is a one where when you release a product to the customer, there are known flaws, but customer accept that one, any of that part, we are not using it, that one, you can submit, right? We deploy and start using it, the other part of the other features of the product, right? But the known faults are not being touched upon, used and all, right? With that assurance, with that understanding, people release it, right, with a known bug, known faults and all, then later they try to correct those things. This is one aspect. The same corrective maintenance, the other aspect is that one, everything is all right, you deploy and the customer, they find it, there is a bug, there is a flaws in that, operational issues and all these things, they will ask you to do that correction, right? And against their requirements specified and all, maybe a wrong design, wrong coding, or not perceiving it properly, whatever it may be, right? So you do correction of that. So all that will go in agreed, as per the agreed documents only. The all corrective maintenance goes as per the agreed documents, as far as the requirement specifications are concerned. But when you get into, this is one type of maintenance and we call as a corrective maintenance. Whereas adaptive maintenance, okay, is a one, which speak about, right, change in the feature. They wanted a new feature, right? How exactly you are going to add that one? They say we wanted the extension. We wanted a new ways of doing it. And for that, there will be new set of fun agreements, new set of requirements and all. And you need to accommodate all the changes, right, in your software. This is we call as adaptive maintenance. You how to make your product adapt to the new changes that is being suggested. Probably for that, the charging will be different, requirements will be different, timelines will be different. Okay, all the things will be different, right? These are the two kinds of things. Arpita and Ashish, you cannot done, right? List and explain the different types of software maintenance, right? This is the one, right? Explain, Arpita, note it.
Sir, can you repeat it? I lost my connection.
Just... Yeah. List and explain the various types of software maintenance. List and explain the various types of software maintenance. This is one question. The other question is, right, okay, explain with example the various features of a programming language. Explain with example the various features of the programming language you have studied. Right? That enables code and design maintenance. Explain with example the various programming various features of the programming language you have studied that enables the code and design maintenance. Mark it as an important thing. Right? So here you'll be talking about object orientation, you'll be talking about encapsulation, we'll be talking about the polymorphic calls, which already we explained about that, how polymorphic call enables code, the design maintenance and all, right? Maintenance is I wanted to do adapt to change. How do it easily do? I wanted encapsulation. How does it do, right? I want to change internal data structure. How does it help, right? So by restricting, right, the impact of the change within that particular class, right, and with restricting that one so that it helps you to do better maintenance because other parts are not getting affected at all. That is the advantage of layered architecture also. Are you getting it? Right? So you can explain about different aspect of that. Arpita, you have to enter that in our in-class question bank. Right after this.
Yes, sir.
Right. Yes. And all other questions, whatever it is there at the end of the chapter, you put it there. Right? See that today you complete. Right? Got it. Then you can note down another question, right? List and explain, right, the various UI design issues. List and explain with example the various UI design issues. Noted, Arpita?
Yes, sir.
Yeah. The another thing, another question already you noted, but still you continue saying that consider the following UI, right? Study, right? And and list, study and list the various issues associated with its operational aspect from user perspective. Right? And some UI will be given to you. Correct. Already a few examples we have given in Google class. You note down that. They are just simple example. Okay, that's very clear about that. Right? Yes. Now shall we continue with the agile practices and all? And thereby we say bye to this particular class. Right? This particular topic. Right? Then we will get into the next one. Now here, is it visible to you all people? Document whatever I'm showing. Document whatever I'm showing, is it visible to you? Arpita? Abhishek Pujari?
Yes.
That's good. Right. Now what we were talking
about. Yes, it is visible.
Okay, that's good. Right. Now look at that. In the last class, we were talking about the agile practice, agile method. Agile method is nothing but quickly moving. Right? People, if you look at the waterfall model or generic iterative or life cycle, whatever it is there, people don't have a time for 3 to 24 months or 1 month, 2 months time to get into the product, part of the product feature, which is operational in nature. People wanted very quickly. Weekly basis, can you produce something, right? So here are the few marking. I kept it in the book. You can go through that one, right? And extreme programming is one such things, right? Wherein pair programming is a one important aspect. And even your stakeholder, they are associated with you. You talk to them. You cannot say that when my requirement is frozen, my design is frozen, then I start doing my programming and then I deliver it. No, people don't have a patience. Rather than a patience, I'll say, people are not interested in that. Can you make my things to work quickly, part by part, right? So, right, that's right. That's why it's being said here, quickly, simultaneous phases, we say, right? Here, you analyze, you design, you code, and you test and release it in just 2-3 days. And you interact with the same customer there, make customer be part of your team, discuss with them, take requirements there only, and work on that and release it within 3-4 days or a week or so. This is a core principle of an agile practice. Agile in the sense, quickly move in the sense, release the features to the end user so that they can start using it quickly. Don't make them to wait for 1 month, 6 months, 1 year and all. No, right? Within a week, can you produce something, right? So are you okay with this? The terms, explain the following term, not on this. Explain the following term. explain the following term: agile practice Arpita, you need to acknowledge me.
Yes, sir.
Right. Second one in that, extreme programming. Third one is,
yes, sir.
Third one is pair programming, pair, P-A-I-R, pair programming. Right. So you need to understand all those things. Right. Now I'm going back right here. Okay, to speak to you about something. I told you about the waterfall model, right? Iterative model where what I'm saying, extreme programming, right? The core part of this extreme programming is working in pairs. Look at this cursor, right? And writing tests first, right? You get it to use pair programming and we do write test first. I mean, test in the sense, test case are written first, and according to the test case, right, what you do is you write a coding. Simple example, your quadratic equation, you take it. What is the test case? I'll say that one, if when A equal to 0, B equal to 0, C equal to 0, these are not a quadratic equation, right? Can your program respond to that? Write a program to ensure A equal to 0, B equal to 0, C equal to 0. Now what I'll do is I'll give a test case, and the test case A equal to something, B equal to something, B, C equal to something, which is a quadratic equation. Okay, solutions are right equal. Right, get me right code for that. Right, then A equal to something, B equal to something, C equal to something, where you, it is a quadratic mean nature. Right, and you have a solutions are not equal. Then it is imaginary. Right, okay, this, whatever that component you get it, all four input you provide, right, then accordingly you write the code. The test cases are thought first and the coding is created according to this. Right, so is that clear? Right?
Yes.
Right. There are a lot of stories that gets into, please go through all that things, right? I'm not okay, taking you through all that things. But the another important thing which I would like to take you through is, wait for that, where are these? Yeah. These all things, okay, are marked there, that okay, you can see it, right? As a part of okay, how to be an agile, how to quickly move, right? It's being said that it is agile methods are a method or the process, okay, is a way of working. Please understand that agile method is a way of working, the way of doing a project, right? And these agile methods follow the what is called agile philosophy, and agile philosophy includes extreme programming and scrum, right? Please note down that I explain the following, that you are taken agile method, second one you have taken extreme programming, third one you have taken as a pair programming, you add scrum, S-C-R-U-M. This is one of the popular term that is being used. Please go through that. It is nothing but a philosophy. It is a project management process. How do you do it? Right? Are you getting this? But one of the important feature, okay, is look at that. This is the most important thing, right? In case of an agile kind of things, development, software development, you go for individuals and interaction over process and tools. The individuals and interaction take a priority right here as a design principle, as a part of methodology in agile. Working software over comprehensive documentation. Customer collaboration over contract negotiation, right? Customer collaboration, you are, okay, you freeze everything on paper and then start doing it. No, it is there in a paper, it is not there in a paper, no. Involve the customer, okay, as a part of your development activity, and okay, on site, you discuss with them, what is that required? Oh, this is what is required, develop it. Again, you have a stand-up meeting on next some other time, and okay, all changes, all requirements collected there only, and keep on doing it rather than focusing on, okay, well, well documented requirements and work on that. Right? The fourth point is important, responding to the changes who are following a plan. You have planned accordingly, I'm doing it. Don't tell me anything. No. Responding to the change. Say it's something the people, they say it now. Then when you're doing afternoon after the lunch, they come and say, no, do like this. You accommodate that. You accommodate that for, because you are doing a small part of that, releasing in this week, then taking a next increment in the next week. Right? Every small increment, small changes, small size, deliver that and get into the next one. Are you clear about that? This particular book, I've kept it in my Google class. You can refer it. All documents are made available, reading material. Right? And even PPTs of UI and UX design will be made available, right, by today or tomorrow in the Google class. You can go through that. We'll make it available. Right? Are you clear about the 4 points?
Yes. Yes, sir.
Right. Earlier we were telling you do requirements, you do design, then freeze everything, check it and all, get into that one. Now we are saying something. Right? So all that initial plan will be there. Then quickly what you do is, chalo, come on, this week we are going to do this one. What is that you wanted? You wanted this, 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 this way? Yeah, start doing it. Okay, collect that with the meeting. Okay, design for that there. Then work in that, work for that. And any changes there, do that one. Only small increments, release it. It starts working, that part. Then pick the next one, right? That is the basic principles of an agile, like a quickly moving pattern. People feel that, right, there is something, useful things are happening. So there are certain principles behind the Agile Manifesto, right? List and explain the various principles of agile practice. Arpita, you can note down. Add it in our in-class question bank.
Yes, sir.
This is not the textbook recommended for you, but we are referring it. I wanted you to go through this. So look at that, certain principles. I'll read one or two, right? Our highest priority is the case to satisfy the customer through early and continuous delivery of valuable software. You cannot say that one, you didn't tell it before, so I will not do it. No, he's telling now, take it, add it and release it. And you cannot ask them that one, it will be delivered after 6 months. No, this week, next week, like that. Then look at that, second point. Welcome changing requirements, even late in the development. Agile processes harness the changes for the customer's competitive advantage. Right? When you are coding, during that, your customer will walk in into your cabin and say that, well, no, you do this one in this way. You cannot say, you didn't tell it before, right? It was not there in requirement specification, right? No. Right? That's why, because you're taking a small path for a weak assignment, doing that increment and giving it, and you allow the customer to change the requirements at any point of time, even when you are coding. Look at third point. Deliver working software frequently. Oh, that's so nice. Hope you are understanding this, Arpita.
Yes, sir.
Deliver working software frequently, even in your project also. Right? Got it. That means you feel that, oh, something is making a progress. Maybe in your home, when function, big function, you organize, your father or grandfather, what they're doing is, some task is distributed to you, your sister, your brother, your elder brother, your younger brother, all the things. And each one of you, when you report it, no, I have purchased this, I've gone to market, completed this. Your father or grandfather feel that, oh, there is a progress is happening. I've given a task, your grandfather says, I've given a task to you, no one is reporting. One day is over, 2 days over, next Monday is a function, guests are coming, what to do? Nobody has reported. I don't know whether grocery items, all purchase happened or not. All nothing. Right? So people wanted frequent, right? Working softwares frequently. They're getting that maybe in the small piece, Right? So you as a agile practitioner, right? You have to deliver this working software frequently. Welcome changes at any time. Deliver working software piece frequently, right? Customer is highest priority for you, right? Look at the fourth one. business people and developers must work together daily throughout the project. Yeah, look at that. How? Right? That's nice. Right? Build projects around a motivated individual. Okay, all that things. But up to 4 point, there sounds good. Developer and business people, they work together on a daily basis. Softwares are delivered frequently. Right? Changes, okay, are of requirement anytime. Right? Highest priority for the customer. Right? And continuous delivery of valuable software. Right? So like this, there are many points that you get into. Right? Look at that. At a regular intervals, the team reflects on how to become more effective. That is another thing. Maybe 1 week, first week you delivered something, people are not happy about that. Like this, that and all. You do, they interact, they tell you negative points, all the things. And next week you do better. So that within a short period, you will start doing much better. Right? Are you understanding that highlighted point? At regular intervals, the team
yes,
reflects
sir.
On how to become more effective. Okay, then tunes and adjusts its behavior accordingly. It is true with your mini project also. Demonstrate your mini project regularly to your guide weekly basis, right? Or at least okay, once in a fortnight. So that right, you can do better. Otherwise, what happens is okay, during the examination 1 week before, you take a project report and dump it in front of your guide and say that one that we have done it. Then guide will say, do this, do this, do this. Then you say, we don't have a time, next week is exam. Right? Finally, what happens? Right? Your project is utter failure. Right? Are you getting it? So we wanted to be in agile. Right? Agile practices are necessary. Right? Follow it. Right? Are you clear about this? Hello? Arpita?
Yes, sir.
Right. So these are all experience that you will get it, right? Some are theoretical. You cannot ask me illustrate this, right? But whereas you are designed, yes, there is an illustration that is planned next week, second part. And already I have given few examples. Okay, hope you can refer that. Where is that? In class question back learning material. GUI sample study for reusability. Right. You can look into that. What is that? Back to classroom. Is that problem some? Why there is it not okay here? Right, we'll see that. Okay, it is there. I think probably there's not a problem here and all. You can open up and see that one. Anyhow, if I okay refer it and show it, my desktop repository of that. My course here. Sample scenarios. Videos, programs, samples, maybe I might have to put here. Right. Poor usability. Okay, good error message. Now look at the good error message. Right. And you asked, okay, Sarthak to pick few examples of that. Right. See here in this case, hope. Yeah. Is it visible, Arpita? Right. Now look
yes,
that
is visible.
Yeah, that's good. Right. Here, look at that. The cursor here. Okay, step one, step two, step three. That will, okay, navigation steps that will help you. Right. That still how many, okay, forms you need to fill or how many steps are there to complete the work. Is it not a comfort zone of, right, for the user? Arpita? Arpita?
Yes, sir.
Right. Now look at right. You have to frequently respond to me. Right. Now look at the cursor
yes,
here. Right. You can go to the previous one. Okay. This one navigation that is also being provided. So that when once you fill something a stage and you find that there is something changes required that you can go to the previous page and correct that things and come back also. Am I right?
Yes, sir.
Right. Now look at that. When user ID, password, confirm password you have entered, right, sometimes you get that is incorrect. Okay, what is incorrect and all? Okay, you need to tell, no? You have to give a message to the end user, user of this particular product, what went wrong. Yesterday I was telling about the date. You entered the correct date. Today is 7/7/11/2020. But my system says that one incorrect date. Hey, yeah, today's date is 7th only, November only, 2020 only. What is incorrect? Okay, rather than saying incorrect incorrect date, this is a wrong message. Rather than that, what you can do is enter the date in the format DDMMYY. So the user response, when you educate the user, user feels comfortable. And that's what is an user experience. People feel comfortable. Right? When they feel comfortable, when they don't feel comfortable, capture their experience of good and bad and incorporate here. Right? User experience, when we talk about that, the user behavior we capture and accommodate that. And also, what kind of good or bad feeling experience that you are giving to your end user about your product. Do they feel comfortable? Now look at one example. I type the password and confirm the password. Right? Old password and whatever it is. And there is something not satisfying the password rules, whatever it may be. These many character, this is a special, whatever it is there. Now the response is the new password must contain at least two numeric character. That means I have not entered two numeric character. Will it not be good one? Will it not be good one? You are educating,
yes.
You are educating the end user. This is called, now as a, the first time user of computer or the email while creating an account, when I get a response like that, I get educated, right? My mind is not floating here and there. I'm not in a confusing state. Many times we find when you are using the product and all, what to do next? I'm not getting what to do, how to install, what is the next step? Then we throw that one. That's a bad, your product is giving a bad experience to the end user. Arpita, am I right? Right? And your product is giving good experience. Your product, now look at that, your product is giving good experience. It is telling that one, gentlemen, look at that, two numeric characters are required. Educate the people. Educate. Your software should educate the end users. Hope you are understanding that what I'm saying. Is that clear?
Yes, sir.
Right. So, such a kind of an example, okay, different people will quote about that. This is part of yesterday's session also, please take it, right? And I'll be asking him the second part, right, giving all this, how it's being designed, right? So it is there, you can see all the things, poor designs, right? Is it visible? Is it visible?
Yes, it is visible.
Now look at that. This is a long back. You can see that one on 2008. Okay, what were you people were doing in 2008? In which standard you were there? Arpita?
I guess third.
Yeah.
Third child or fourth child.
Yeah, yeah. Now look at that. At the time, this is the thing what we were teaching software engineering then. Right? So look at this. Right, okay, file is being attached and we were sending it, right, and we get an error. Okay, see, a server error occurred and your email was not sent. 008. What should I do with this? What should I do with this? Is it educating the user that rather than saying that one, why it did not attach? Why it was, okay, why okay, it has not sent that one? If that error, if you display that one, user feel comfortable. Am I right, Arpita? Am I right?
Yes, sir.
Right. So this is, look at that. This particular product is not giving the good user experience. This particular product, okay, is not captured what user feel comfortable in reading error message and all these things. This is one of the popular email today you find it. Right? Look at the other examples. Right. This is the example which we have quoted and asked you take it as an assignment and do it. Right. There is nothing. Right. Now, this is what I want you to do. You as an end user, find out that, okay, how comfortable you are. What changes required? You need to write it. A good exercise. Right? Good exercise. Are you clear about this? And
yes,
each answer will be different. Each other answer will be different. Right? But let me not explain about this. So all these things we have put it in your Google class. Please go to that. Now, there is a deviations that we had, right? Fine. Hope you appreciate all these things, the principles behind Agile, okay, manifesto, right? Please note down all these things. It is there in the book, whatever I have given. Please go through that. All this yellow marking, I'll put it there so you can read that, right? So there are many other things here and there, little bit you can get into. It is not completely whatever I have covered, that is enough for that now, right? Not too many things, right? So this is okay, all about what we were talking, right, till now, right? Are you clear about this? This is about the unit number 3. Today we have completed unit number 3, right? But anyhow, UI design will continue in the next week as an add-on class, right? On Monday, my 10:30 class, there will be one external session again on architecture. I told you that I'll be doing it, right? So you'll be attending for that in my regular class only, 10:30, right? External, okay, external to this, okay, group, right? Okay, that speaker will be talking about some architecture, very popular architecture used in almost every product, business product that you'll see around. That will see it. Then, okay, that is on Monday. Then Tuesday, we don't have a class. And from 11th, right, onwards, yes, we will go through the verification validation. We have got 2 weeks time, next week and next to next week. And your IA2 begins from 25th of November. Am I right?
Yes, sir.
Oh, right. Just check it, right? Then by the time, 2 weeks, we will be covering the unit number 4 part of that. That's what, okay, we are planning here. Look into that. This is part of this is for IA2, part of this is for IA3. And this is the most important thing, testing. Then project management, cost estimation, okay, resource estimation, okay, people capability maturity model, right, risk and all, configuration management, project management aspect of that, we will see as a part of IA number 3. That you will spend around 7 classes for that later, right? This is how we are planning to move right ahead of this, right? So today we have completed unit number 3. Please go through the textbook, every line of that, about software maintenance, about evolution process, about legacy systems and all, right? This. Are you clear? Please go through the textbook, every line of that. With this, we come to the end. It is getting closed also. We come to the end of today's session, right? If you have any questions, right, please do it, right? And today, maybe by after 1 hour or something, you will get a feedback on yesterday's training program. I wanted you people to sincerely give a training feedback to all, right? That will help us to do better. And yesterday, the person was from security architect from Akamai Technologies and all. Whatever they speak is okay, based on their experience, right? We need to visualize, we need to look into that and get into, right? Quickly, right? Such kind of several such things we will arrange and you to adapt to such kind of learning environment also. And there will be assignment will be put in your Google class today, right? It is about, okay, Adobe XD, UI design for your okay mini project. Please do that. You'll get 1 week time, 7 days will be deadline, right? So whether it comes in Google Class immediately or not, but we have made it known to all, please work in your project group and do that very sincerely. That is an outcome of okay, listening to UI and UX design. All right. Is that okay, Arpita? Shall we close now? Shall we end the meeting?
Yes, sir. Yeah.
Any other question people wanted to interact with me about this, about anything about software engineering or any class we have conducted so far, not limited to what we are doing it. You are free to interact with me anytime through CRs. Right? All assignment you are supposed to submit by 8 tomorrow. Please ensure that you keep everything in your Google class, in your drive. Give a short URL separately for all assignment. Upload URL. Do not upload in my Google class the PDF file or Word file, whatever it is. That everything you have to keep it in your drive, and its short URL, right, is to be submitted to me. And you have to ensure that all are intact there. Right? It may be evaluated at any point of